I want to continue with our generalization of the determinant to n by n matrices. We already talked about the Laplace expansion, which is a way of taking an n by n matrix and then writing it as a sum of n minus 1 by n minus 1 determinants to find the determinant of an n by n. Here I'm going to show you another formula. It's called the Leibniz formula, or some mathematicians call it the big formula. And that one, we're going to start again with the 3 by 3 matrix, and then I will show you how that generalizes to n by n. So let's write down the determinant of the 3 by 3 matrix again. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I. And here, let me reorder the term slightly. So we have A, E, I. And then another term that has an A is the other diagonal, so A, F, H, and that gets a minus sign. Then we have B, F, G. And the other term that has a B that gets the minus sign is B, D, I. Finally, we have C, so we have C, D, H. And the term with the minus sign is CEG. Okay? There are six terms here. Let's look at them a little bit more closely. AEI has A is coming from the first row, E from the second row, I from the third row. But even more than that, E is in a different column than A, and I is in a different column than A and E, right? Same with A, F, H. A comes from the first row, F from the second, H from the third. And F is in a different column than A, and H is in a different column than A and F. And every term is like that, okay? So every term here is in a unique row and a unique column. So how many terms are there? So for the 3 by 3 matrix, right? In the first row, you have a choice of three terms. The second row, because you've chosen one of the terms in the first row, the second row, you have a choice of two terms, so three times two. And in the last row, you only have a choice of one term. So there are three times two times one equals three factorial terms. Okay? So a 3 by 3 matrix has six terms, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. An n by n matrix, if we follow the same procedure, how do we compute the determinant of an n by n matrix? Each term here has to come from one row and one column that is unique. So we start in the first row, we take an element from the first row, we go to the second row, and we choose an element that's not in the same column as the element that we chose from the first row. Then we go to the third row, and we don't choose the columns of the previous two elements, and so on. So we have n factorial terms. So that's why it's called the big formula, because n factorial becomes a very large number when n is large. Okay? So that's the idea of computing the determinant from the Leibniz formula. The complication is, how do you determine which terms have a plus sign and which terms have a minus sign? So we can try to figure that out here. So let me make a table, and then we can figure out why some of these terms are positive and some of these terms are negative. So I'm going to have the term. And then I want to figure out, let me write down the headings first, and then I'll explain to you. So it will be term, and then it will be the column order, and then the sign, and then number of flips, and then the sign of the term, okay? So let's work this out. So let's consider the first term. So the first term is A, E, I. What's the column order of A, E, I? So A comes from column 1, So we're doing an order of the rows. So the rows are going 1, 2, 3. So what are the order of the columns? A is from column 1, E is from column 2, I is from column 3. So I'm going to write this as 1, 2, 3. Okay. What is the sign of that term? That's a plus. Okay. What is the number of flips from 1, 2, 3 to get 1, 2, 3? Okay, that's the meaning of number of flips. So how many interchanges we have to make of 1, 2, 3 to get 1, 2, 3? That's 0 interchanges. And then the type 0 will be an even number, so I'm going to call that even. Okay, you'll see why this makes sense in a moment. That's the first term here, AEI. The next term is AFH. What are the column orders here? Column 1, column 3, column 2. 1, 3, 2. The sign is negative. And then how many permutations do we need to make to go from 1, 2, 3 to 1, 3, 2? The easier way to do it is how many permutations we need to make to go from 1, 3, 2 to 1, 2, 3. Here you just need to permutate 2 and 3, so it's just one permutation. So the number of permutations, which I'm calling here the number of flips, is 1. 1 is an odd number, so that's odd. Okay? Go to the next one, B, F, G. What is the column order here? It's 2, 3, 1. 2, 3, 1. The sign is plus. Then how many permutations we need to do of these numbers to get back 1, 2, 3? Here we permute 1 and 2, so it becomes 1, 3, 2, right? 1, 3, 2. And then we have to permute 3 and 2. So 1, 3, 2, and then to 1, 2, 3. So you need to do two permutations here to get from 2, 3, 1 to 1, 2, 3. 2 is an even number, so I write down even here. BDI. BDI, the next term, is 2, 1, 3. That's a negative sign. How many permutations to get to 1, 2, 3? You just change 1 and 2. So one permutation, and that one is odd. CDH. CDH is 3, 1, 2. CDH is a plus sign. How do we get from 3, 1, 2 to 1, 2, 3? Well, let's put 1 in the first slot, so then it becomes 1, 3, 2, and then we have to permute the 3 and the 2. So 1, 3, 2, and then 1, 2, 3. So we need two flips of these numbers, two permutations. 2 is an even number, okay? And then the last one, C, E, G, that's 3, 2, 1, 3, 2, 1. That gets a minus sign. How do we get from 3, 2, 1 to 1, 2, 3? We just interchange 1 and 3, right? So that's just one permutation or one flip, and that one is odd. Okay. So if you look at this table, you see that your choice of columns then, what is the number of permutations to go from 1, 2, 3 to your choice of columns in constructing this term? If the number of permutations is even, you get a plus sign. If it's odd, you get a minus sign, right? Even plus odd minus, even plus odd minus, even plus odd minus, okay? So that's the rule. That's the rule for the signs. So let me see if I can write that down. So you get a even permutations. Are plus and odd permutations. R minus, okay? And that's the permutation of the column order starting from 1, 2, 3 through N, okay? So that's the Leibniz formula. It's a very lengthy calculation when N is large, but certain matrices actually might be the simplest way to compute the determinant. So let's quickly review. To compute the determinant of an N by N matrix, you need to write down N factorial terms, okay, a large number of terms. And if you got a lot of zeros in the matrix, a lot of the terms will be zero, and you make use of that. And the trick is to figure out what are the signs of all the terms. The plus sign is when the choice of the columns is an even permutation of 1, 2, 3 through N. And the minus sign is when the choice of the columns is an odd permutation of 1, 2, 3 through N. I'm Jeff Chasnov. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.